Hello, 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 amigos. Welcome one, welcome all. It's time for another exciting edition of The Show With No Name on Vaughn Radio, and it's time for Liftoff.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, ignition, liftoff, liftoff, 30 minutes after the hour.
Get ready. Hold on to your hats.
Strap on your seatbelt.
Fasten your seatbelts.
Hold on to your hats.
Get ready for the ride of your life.
The Show With No Name.
It's Show With No Name time. On Vaughn Radio.
It's
the
Show With No Name.
Let's go.
That's right. That's right, amigos. Welcome aboard. Welcome aboard. I know it's always rough on a Monday, but we'll get through it together, amigos. Trust me. We'll get it together. We'll get through it. And all the other gets there are as well. As we get into today's show, the very useful get. Oh, man. You can't get around it. No lo puedes evitar. You can't get by without it. No puedes salir del paso sin ello. So get over it. Así que supéralo. You get it? Don't get me wrong. No me malinterpretes. Oh, man. A lot of uses of the verb to get. And a lot of my students like to try and get around it, evitarlo, but you really got to get into it because it can help you. It can be so useful. As you know, it's our reflexive too. So get drunk, get tired, to get happy, ponerse, hacerse. And it depends here. Now, if you're American, you say get, got, gotten. If you're British, you don't. You say get, got, got. So a lot of times when I hear my students say got there in the third column, it sounds weird to me, but it's not wrong. It's not wrong. As you guys know, a lot of people speak English, and a lot of those people are not even native speakers. They're from other countries, and English is their second language, which is the case for many of you guys, my students. English is your second language, and let me be the one to tell you, you are kicking ass. Seriously kicking ass. I mean, we have started off the year with, as we say in English, to start off the year with a bang. I think you say por la puerta grande. We've started off with a bang. You guys have been kicking butt since we came back from our Christmas break at the beginning of the month. Can you believe that that was just a couple weeks ago? Oh my God, time flies. And that's something we always say here on the show. Time flies when you're having fun. And not just on this program, but remember, you've got tons of amazing programs on Vaughn Radio, from Fitz's program, No Excuses, which is right before this show. You can't think of a better way to warm up. Let's pronounce that word, warm up. It's like saying war, guerra, and then mup, warm up. So there's no better way to warm up than with my buddy Fitz. He's the guy who trained me. Every time people say, oh, Alberto, you're a great teacher, you're an awesome, I always say, look at Fitz. I mean, he gave me the tool. Obviously, you either have it in you or you don't, right? I think it's a calling, es una vocación, being a teacher. Because normally people don't get into teaching because of the money, right? I mean, there are certain jobs you don't get into because of money. You get into because it's a calling. It's something you feel led to do, right? To feel led, viene del verbo lead. Algo te lleva ahí, te dice, tienes que hacer eso. You feel led to do it. And that's something with me with teaching. I mean, I wanted to be an actor. And the reason I wanted to be an actor was quite simple. You know, in retrospect, it's really easy. We always say hindsight is always 20/20. 20/20 is visión perfecta. 20 in this eye, 20 in this eye. And hindsight is mirando hacia atrás, retrospectiva. It's always easy to say this stuff in retrospect when you're looking back at it, right? And of course, I just lost my train of thought. I was trying to teach you so many expressions that I lost my train of thought. Bueno, apúntate esa. To lose your train of thought, it's something that happens to me. The older I get, the more it seems to happen. Y estamos con unas frases, the more, the more. Remember, if you want to practice any of these things, such as get, we kicked off today's show, we got into the show, nos metimos en ello, with the verb to get. You know, you can get, ahí lo tienes sin querer, tons of different materials that are either to work on things in general or to work on specific things. So if you want to work on phrasal verbs or you want to work specifically on pronunciation or you want to work the gamut, si quieres trabajarlo todo, from A to Z, you've got it all. It's at our Vaughn tienda. You've got materials, I mean, all over the place. And I'm working on some new ones myself, which I can't tell you what, but I am working hard at work on some new stuff. I already have 4 books at the Vaughn tienda. And if you guys haven't checked out those books, the 4 of them, let me see if I remember them. I have to go in order. I'll tell you that, or else I will forget them. You've got English Everywhere. Then you've got This Book Is the Milk. Then you've got This Book Is the Remilk, which you can't get anymore. So if you can still get a copy, un ejemplar of This Book Is the Remilk, grab it. Get a copy. Otra vez el get ahí. Get a copy because that book is, well, it's a collector's item now because it's been reissued now with audio and a new title and a new cover. And it's called This Book Is the This Book Is the Milk 2. Que es también y también also. And the latest book I've published was English on the Go, and that's Aprende Inglés Viajando por el Mundo. And those of you who bought This Book Is the Milk too, thank you. Thank you so much. Also, if you're looking for something a little more, you're looking for a boost, un aumento, you're looking for that push, that little extra punch in your English, well, remember, you can contact us over at Grupo Vaughn. .com, and we've got everything. I mean, from very affordable, que no son muy caros, very affordable online courses, materials, as I said, we've got them coming out the wazoo. Toma frase nativa. Saliendo por todas partes, o sea, a tutiplén. We've got materials, English materials coming out the wazoo. Another thing, make sure you're following us on social media. That's the easiest way to make sure that you're getting a little something every day, even if you miss these shows. And you don't have to miss these shows, obviously, because you can tune in wherever you listen to podcasts. So if you want to find out about anything in the Vaughn world, from our online courses to Vaughn radio information to the Disney English with Kids or my favorite one, and hopefully this will be the year, 2023, when I get to go to Vaughn Town. Listen carefully. Can you hear that? No. Listen closer. I'm not talking about the birds chirping. I'm talking about everybody speaking English and feeling comfortable. Listen. This is what it's like at Vaughn Town, a peaceful place where you can really learn English and lose your inhibitions. There's a reason it's one of our star programs. Vaughn Town, lose your fear of speaking English. If you want more information about this immersive experience, go to GrupoVaughn.com or give us a call. 911-385-8831. Lose your fear of speaking English and express yourself with clarity at Vaughn Town. That's right, folks. If you want more information about Vaughn Town or anything we do, you can go over to GrupoVaughn.com. That's our website. You can contact us on social media, as well as get tons of content every day for free. Or if you're traditional, some people prefer using the horn. It's another way to say the phone. And that is 911-385-8831. Even if you just want some information, let's say you want a free level test, reach out to us, contacta con nosotros, and we'll be able to help you or at least steer you in the right direction. And if you're following us on social media, you'll also do really well in our pop quiz.
Pop quiz, come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Pop quiz. Let's go.
Pop quiz.
Come on. Come on. Wake up. Wake up. Pop quiz. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Pop quiz. Pop quiz. Pop quiz. Pop quiz. Pop quiz. All right. All right, folks. It is our pop quiz. Make sure you're following me and all my buddies on social media. As you guys know, I post at least one video a day, and then I post these little quizzes. I've got to be honest. The one I use the least is Facebook, but I use Instagram. I use Twitter. You'll see me pretty active on both of those. Also on YouTube as well. And as you guys know, I'm constantly producing podcast episodes. And in fact, let me give you guys, I'm going to give you a little sneak peek. See, you'll know about our next episode. Last week, we took a look at bees, right? Yeah. Last week, we took a look at bees. And this week, we're going to take a look at Museum Mile. That's right. Museum Mile located in New York City. Whoa, hang on. There's one in London too. I didn't know that. So as usual, you guys are not the only ones learning. I'm learning stuff every single day by preparing these episodes of the show with no name, by preparing the different episodes of For Your Inglés. I'm forced, me obliga, I'm forced to learn, and I love it. So thanks for making me have to learn stuff so I can teach it to you guys. And then as always, I like to highlight the English around it. So if we're talking about, let's say, in an episode we had on gardening, we're not just going to talk about like fruits and vegetables, but we'll also talk about the expressions that are used that have to do with fruits and vegetables and gardening, such as apples and oranges. Are you familiar with this one? Oh, come on, man. That's apples and oranges. Oh, directamente puedes decir, apples and oranges. What does that mean? No tiene, esto es una que usáis bastante en español también, no tiene nada que ver. That's apples and oranges, man. Estamos comparando dos cosas totalmente. I'll give you the perfect example, as I always like to tell you guys to personalize everything. You know how I use it? When people say, so what do you prefer, Madrid or New York or Spain or the United States? I'm like, it's apples and oranges, man. Like, it's impossible. I can't choose a favorite, if that's what you're asking me. I like them both for different reasons. And there are things that I loathe, detesto, in Spain and in, I mean, I'm a normal person, right? We have things that we like, things that we love, things that we dislike, and things that we loathe. And to loathe is detestar. We can also say to detest. All right, let's take a look at today's pop quiz. This is one that I posted. It was a quiz, a little fill in the blank, but I'm not going to give you guys the options because I think you guys can figure it out on your own. So this is an idiomatic expression that means that you're in a tight spot. Que te acabo de decir otra forma de decirlo. In a tight spot, en un apuro, in a situation that looks bleak, it doesn't look promising. te suena, ¿no? Prometedor. It doesn't look promising. So fill in the blank, but I don't just want you guys to fill in blanks here. We're not doing that. What we're trying to do here is personalize the language and use it. So anybody who's participating, whether you're participating live with us right now or you're listening to the podcast, doesn't matter. This is where you guys get to participate. Okay, say the word if you know it aloud. Even if you can't participate by writing it down, say it aloud. Say the expression until you know it, and then personalize it. And this is another way to make sure that you are familiarizing yourself with it. Okay, so the blank is caught between the blank and the deep blue sea. Okay, again, as I said, it's an expression that has to do with being in a really difficult situation. And you can say that, oh man, I'm in a really difficult situation. You know, I can't find a way out of this here. Okay, a ver cómo lo traducen. I did it the way I thought, but let's see what they say here. Yeah, exactly as I did it. So, entre la espada y la pared. Entre la espada y la pared. Okay, it says here a figurative way of saying I'm facing a dilemma. That's another way. You know that word, dilemma. We say dilemma. No decimos tanto la I latina. We don't say dilemma. We say dilemma. So you're facing, enfrentado con, very logical word. You're facing a dilemma. Now, you can say I'm between a rock and a hard place, but that wasn't the option I gave you, right? Between a rock, tiene todo sentido del mundo. Estoy entre una roca y un sitio duro. Da igual. Doesn't matter where I go here. I'm hitting the same thing. I'm hitting a brick wall. Que también lo decimos. Cuando no haces progreso. I hope you guys never hit a brick wall with your English. So, between a rock and a hard place. Okay, es frase hecha. I guess no es between in a rock. It's between a rock. I'm between a rock and a hard place. Okay, and I think it was AC/DC who says rock and a hard place. There's a lot of groups, obviously, that play with these expressions that have to do with rock for obvious reasons, right? So the one I gave you guys, let's see if anybody got it over here in our virtual chat room. I see a few people have figured it out. It is the devil. So you can say I'm caught or stuck, or just I'm between directamente. You can say the verb can be to be caught, to be stuck, or just to be between a rock and a hard place. And again, it means you're in a difficult, you're facing a dilemma. Me gusta esa definición. And the one that that you guys just gave us here in the chat room and the one we're looking at here is to be caught between the devil and the deep blue sea. Piénsalo también. Okay, si voy a este lado, in both of them, you can visualize somebody having to make a choice. What do I do? Do I hit this rock or do I hit this hard place? Think about it. There's even a Simpsons joke. If you check it out, there's an episode. Put Homer Simpson rock in a hard place and you can find it. So then there's that other one. Between the devil, you look at one side, you look to the right and you say, oh my God, it's the devil. And you look to the other side, you look to the left, right, I can't remember which one I said, left and right, izquierda, derecha, sube, sube, no. And you say, oh my God, there's the deep blue sea. Ahí está el mar, profundo, azul. It means the really deep part of the sea, right? Donde es azul oscuro. You know the part I'm talking about. It's even a movie, Deep Blue Sea. So I'm caught between, or again, you can say I'm caught, I'm stuck, or just directamente, I'm between the devil and the deep blue sea. And it's interesting because I gave you guys a lot of options here. The first option I gave you guys was sword. I try and do that when I put it on Twitter just to see if you know the other words too and just to see how familiar you are with the expressions. So sword. Did you notice how I pronounced that? Sword. I didn't say sword. I said sword. Say it with me. Es como S-O-R-D, sword. Did you say it? Sword. Sword. He's holding a sword. I've heard people say sword, but it sounds really weird to me. Okay? I swear. Es así que se pronuncia. Pero sword, al menos en mi país, in the United States, we don't say sword. We don't say sword. My bad. We do say sword. So it wasn't between the sword, but we did say that the Spanish one is obviously entre la espada y la pared. That's why I tried to confuse you guys. But 17.2% of the people polled, sondeados, said that that was the correct one. 17.2% said sword. 30.2% said wall. Again, I was trying to fool you guys. Not too many people fell for it. Well, altogether, 47.4%. So almost half of you on Twitter, I also put it on Instagram, but almost half of you on Twitter weren't able to get this. Okay, more than half, 52.6%. So just a little over half of the Twitter, the tweet hearts, as I used to call them, although there's not too much sweetness going on Twitter these days. And I want to take a look at this too. A lot of people mispronounce this word. It's not devil. It's devil. 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 The other word, malvado, that word is evil, right? But not devil. I know. Debería ser igual, pero no lo es. That's why I'm pointing it out. Y por eso me gusta destacarlo. We also have a lot of expressions that have to do with the devil as well. You say, speaking of the king of Rome. Hablando del rey de Roma. We say, speaking of or speak of, los dos son aceptados. Speaking of the devil or speak of the devil. Mira quien, it's a way of saying, look, we were just talking about you, right? I like this one, and I'm sure you've heard me say it before. The devil's in the detail or details. Se puede decir de ambos, o singular o plural. The devil is in the detail. And that means that those little details are what make everything. When a lot of, I hate that expression. I got to tell you, it's one of the expressions I hate the most. Oh, that's just a little detail. I'm like, what? Isn't that what makes you different than the other one? And what makes Monet, Monet? And what makes, Picasso, Picasso? Those details? I don't know. So speak of the devil. We use hell a lot, too. We use the, wow. So what the hell? ¿Qué demonios? Who the hell? We use that as well. Oh, another one too. Speaking, let's go to the other side of the spectrum, above the clouds. I've heard people say heaven too. And it's not heaven, it's heaven. Does anybody feel like we're in church today? The devil, another way to say it too, Satan. Does that ring a bell? Satanas, Satan, Satan, the devil. And again, the other side of the spectrum, Jesus Christ, what's other ways to say it? God, the Lord, right? I guess it depends on the Bible verse. I guess it depends on the religion as well. We should have, you know what? And there's a good idea, guys. I'm going to write that down. It's good to write ideas down. If not, you forget them. I'm going to do a religion episode of FYI with none other than, and I think this deserves a drum roll. My mom. Yeah, well, my mom's very religious. She doesn't know too much about other religions. Well, maybe she does. But her specialty is Christianity. Cristianismo, you say? We say Christianity. And I think it would be interesting because, as I told you guys many, many times, I'm not really a religious person, but I really admire faith. La fe. I think there's something beautiful, something that gives people who have faith in something, right? You have to, I really believe that life without faith is nothing. Now, again, just you choose what you have faith in. I think first and foremost, though, even if you have faith in God, you should have faith in yourself first, right? Trust yourself. And if you don't, well, maybe have another problem. It reminds me of the song, oh, well, I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body like me, because I got to have faith, faith, faith. I got to have faith. Is that a name in Spanish? In English, is there anybody named Fe? Because in the States, faith is a pretty popular name. Now, on the other hand, Jesus, unless the person is from Latino descent or, you know, from, like, no American born person without any Latin or Hispanic blood would call their kids Jesus. It's sacrilegious. But again, it's just different. They're cultural differences. Obviously, the people who name their kids Jesus in the Spanish culture are doing that, in honor of Jesus, right? They're doing it. They're saying, you know, that's our God. That's our Jesus. But in the States, people look at it like, how dare you? Nobody has that name. Only the one, the only, the almighty. No, toma otra forma. Todopoderoso, the almighty. All right, guys, we've got to go to a quick commercial break. But we'll be right back with the second part of today's show with no name. So, if I were you guys, I wouldn't even think of going anywhere. Stick around. Welcome back. Welcome back, amigos. Welcome back to this, the second part of today's show with no name on Vaughn Radio. Don't forget, after today's show, you've got the lovely Jules Linares and her program, Let's Get Random. Well, where you'll learn about anything and everything. Un poquito de todo. You'll become a more well-rounded student. Doesn't everybody want to be a little more well-rounded? ¿No lo quiere todo el mundo ser un poco más el equilibrado, redondo, well-rounded? I don't mean, you know, after the holidays. No, I mean as a student, as a human, as a person. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Welcome back to this, the second part of today's show with no name. I hope you guys are enjoying the show, and I hope you're getting down all the vocabulary. I mean, we've looked at a lot of expressions. We looked at just with get, I think we looked at least 6 or 7 different uses of get. You want me to remind you? Okay, but write them down, okay? To get into something, meterte en ello. To get over it, superarlo, to get by, salir del paso, to get on with it, pongámonos en marcha, let's get on with it. I'm trying to think of other ones I may have used. Don't get me wrong, como la canción, don't get me wrong, just like that song. So those are just some of the uses of get. We said the reflexive, emborracharse, ponerse triste, to get drunk, to get sad, to get blue. It's another way of saying sad as well. All right, so my amigos, we're back for the second part, and we've got so much to do. So let's kick off with today's Say What? Say what? What? That's right. That's right, amigos. It's the Say What soundbite, only on the show with no name. That's right, amigos. I hope you came to play and have some fun on the show with no name. Today we've got a classic in today's Say What soundbite. Oh, man. Doesn't get any more classic than this. All right, amigos. As always, I'm going to give you this soundbite four times. You'll have four chances to write everything down. And four chances. I think that's fair enough. On the fifth listen, obviously, I'll tell you right before what we've heard, what the person's saying, any little nuances, matices, and things like that, accent. But at first, I want you guys to give me your first impression. I want you to tell me what you heard, but I want you to use your best English. Don't half-ass it. To half-ass is hacer a medio gas. I love that one. Don't half-ass it. I want you to give it your all. Eso es el inverso. So to half-ass it is hacerlo a medio gas. To give it your all, darlo todo. And I think I've taught you guys this expression before. If it's worth doing, it's worth doing right. I know we've looked at that in the past. So no shortcuts, ningún atajo, no half-assing or any of that stuff. And as always, pay close attention and write down what you hear. This is the Say What soundbite for the first time.
You get this straight, shit kicker. Don't you go mistaking me for some whole other body. You got your brains in your dick if you think we're just going to fade away. We're going to be here till this thing's finished.
Oh, sounds like a happy-go-lucky guy. Do you know this expression? Happy, well, expression. It's an expression slash adjective. Sin preocupaciones. Ah, he's happy-go-lucky. No se molesta con cualquier cosa. I think it's good to be happy-go-lucky. Whenever you can, of course. All right, I'm joking around, obviously. Sounds like somebody who's pretty aggressive. Sounds like the person is angry, and they might even be assaulting someone. Would you say that? And it sounds like there's some kind of bodily injury happening, right? I don't know who. I don't know how. But it sounds like somebody's pissed off. That's my first impression. All right, I'm going to play it for you guys now a second time, and we'll see what you guys get from it. Remember, if you can also pinpoint the accent, if you know where the accent is from, I'd love to hear that as well. And I know a lot of times we don't get into specifics, but we will later. You can just tell me American, British, although British can mean a lot of different accents. American can mean a lot of different accents, even dialects, you know, where we use even different words for things. A perfect example, in the States where I come from, we call refresco, we call it soda. Soda, okay, or soft drinks. In the South, they call it pop. Like pop quiz, P-O-P. I guess it makes sense. If you can make it make sense in your head, but when you pop off the cap, la tapa, what does it go? It goes, right? It makes that pop sound. But we don't, in fact, if we say in the North, in my area, if we say soda pop or pop, we're usually being facetious. We're usually trying to make a little joke, right? Making fun of, burlándose de. All right, so let's hear this again. This is the second listen of today's Say What soundbite. Pay close attention because, well, the person's angry, so it's kind of hard to understand what's being said. Well, we'll see. We'll see by your reaction if this is tough or if it's a piece of cake. Here we go. The second listen of today's Say What soundbite.
You get this straight, shit kicker. Don't you go mistaking me for some whole other body. You got your brains in your dick if you think we're just going to fade away. We're going to be here till this thing's finished.
All right. So I'll continue here. I got some more to say. And on the second, the interesting thing is on the second listen, you always get more stuff. On the second listen, I noticed like a Southern accent. And I got to be honest, or como decimos, truth be told, it's really tough for me. I can't figure out what accent is what from the South. I can tell you that, okay, that person's from the South. But if you ask me now from Georgia, from North Carolina, from Texas, from, you know, I couldn't tell you, te lo juro. I couldn't tell you because it's really difficult. Although I could tell you probably in Spain. I'd be like, I think that's Gadith. But in the States, my ear is not that fine-tuned. Maybe the accent's not so different. Oh, they're going to kill me. If anybody from the South, if any Southerners, Sureños, I want you to look at that a second. South. Pero ya cuando ponemos Southerner, es la misma palabra, South, pero no se pronuncia South. No es Southerner. It's Southerner, somebody from the South. And I know with the South, we get a bad rap. Recibimos mala reputación de la gente. We get a bad rap, as we say in the South. They say we don't know how to talk. They say this, but you know what? That happens everywhere. Think about that. In the South of the United States, we're like, those guys in the South don't know how to talk. And here in Spain, too, when really everybody talks the way they were taught to talk. So they talk the way, anytime I remember British people, when I first started teaching, I said tomato. And they're like, it's tomato. And I was like, yeah, cool, but no. And they're like, oh, it's tomato. I'm like, you think, look at me now, look at me right in the face here. You think I'm going to trust you over my mom? Nope. My mom, my grandma, everybody I know has said the word tomato constantly all my life. Now you, some guy in a pub here watching a soccer match, is telling me it's tomato. Sorry. I'm sorry. I trust my mom. I don't trust you. But it's a very British thing. I know a lot of times they do it jokingly, but they try and correct Americans. And I don't know, maybe it's an issue of pride, or I honestly think it's just more fun. You know, the British sense of humor, if you notice, their sense of humor is making fun of themselves. You know, Brits, they're always saying, yeah, we love England, but they're the first ones to shit on England, right? They're the first ones to be like, oh, mate, this place is horrible. This country, you know. So, you know, they're self-critical and their sense of humor is a little bit drier. Of course, I'm generalizing. I know people who are like that in Spain. I know people who are like that in Asia. I know people who are like that in the Americas and all over the world. You'll find all kinds of people in all kinds of places. All right. Well, folks, that's what Say What is about, hearing all those different accents and seeing if we can get down what's being said. Let's go on over to today's Spelling Bee.
Spelling Bee. Spelling Bee. Spelling Bee. Spelling Bee. Spelling Bee.
That's right, folks. That's right. It is our Spelling Bee. I'm going to spell six words for you right now. And what you guys have to do is tell me what these six words are and what they have in common. And I can tell you today, for the first time in a long time, they don't have to be capitalized. Okay? They are not proper nouns. They all have something in common, but they are not proper nouns. You don't have to start with a capital letter. All right, as always, the first time I am going to fly through this because that's what I have to do. You guys leave me no other choice. No me dejáis otra elección. So this is round one of today's Spelling Bee. Are you ready? Grab your pens. Born to Iron Man. Are you ready? Here we go. The first word is S-E-V-E-N-T-H space H-E-A-V-E-N. The next one is C-L-O-U-D space N-I-N-E. The next one is T-O space T-H-E space N-I-N-E-S. Ooh, we're going fast here. The next one, S-I-X space F-E-E-T space U-N-D-E-R. The next one is N-I-N-E space T-O space F-I-V-E. And the last one is T-H-I-R-D space D-E-G-R-E-E. Whew. I am out of breath. I'll tell you that right now, my amigos. In fact, let's get a little beat going. I'm missing our beat. You know, we usually put a little beat on during the show just to get things going. And on a Monday, who doesn't need a little extra push? Alexa, a little extra oomph, as we say. Oomph, energía. Great word. O-O-M-P-H. Reminds me of the word Oompa Loompas, you know, from Oompa Loompa Doompity-Doo, from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Do we say chocolate? No. We say chocolate. Chocolate, two syllables. All right, let's see if anybody got today's spelling bee words on the first go. I'm checking out our chat room over here, and let's see what we've got. Not yet. I'll give you another 30 seconds or so, and then we're going to go through that list again. Ready? Going once. Going twice. All right. Let's do it. It's time for round two. This is a round for everybody. I'll even lower the beat a little bit. And this is a nice pace. Un ritmo placentero. Here we go. The first word in today's spelling bee. S-E-V-E-N-T-H. Space. H-E-A-V-E-N. The second word, C-L-O-U-D, space, N-I-N-E. Let's go to the third one, T-O, space, T-H-E, space, N-I-N-E-S. You got it? Let's go on to number four. Number four, S-I-X, space, F-E-E-T, space, U-N-D-E-R. The next one, N-I-N-E, space, T-O, space, F-I-V-E. And the last one. T-H-I-R-D, space, D-E-G-R-E-E. All right. No excuses now, folks. Doesn't get any easier than that. All right. Let's go on over to the chat room. Taking a look. And yes. We have got some winners. They say the third time is a charm. A la tercera va la vencida. But with you guys, the second time's a charm. And hey, that's interesting. Because today we're looking at idiomatic expressions that have to do with numbers. So there's your first one, and it's not even part of our list. The third time's a charm. A la tercera va la vencida. I think this would be the translation. But you guys didn't need a third lesson. You got it on the second listen. All right, let's take a look at these. If you guys would like to add some, feel free. There are countless, hablando de números, countless idiomatic expressions that have to do with numbers. You could probably write a book on these. I'm telling you. All right. The first one, seventh heaven. The expression, seventh heaven. I don't know if you guys remember. Maybe in Spain they called it something else. But there was a special TV show. It was on the air from, well, the first episode aired in 1997. No, 1996. All right, so Are you familiar with it? I never watched it. I knew it was really, really popular. I do remember everybody, oh, Seventh Heaven tonight. I never caught it. But I caught the meaning behind the name. And the expression is to be in seventh heaven. It's interesting because we don't put the. We normally say the eighth person, the ninth, cuando usamos el ordinal. Aquí no. I'm in seventh heaven. Okay? Yeah, I've never seen it used with the. I'm in seventh heaven. It's when you've reached a feeling of bliss. The word bliss, dicha, alegría, felicidad, total. It's a Muse song, bliss. All right, so this, I'm in seventh heaven. Estoy en la gloria, I think would be. Same thing, la gloria is heaven for you guys. The next one has to do with the sky too. But this one, remember, we got a different preposition and that's just as important as you guys know. So I'm in seventh heaven. That means I'm over the moon. I'm feeling great. I'm really happy. I'm elated. Another way to say it is to be on cloud nine. But look, I'm in seventh heaven. I'm on cloud nine. Write them down. It's not the same. I had a student tell me, I'm in the seventh cloud. And I said, I got you. So to be on cloud nine, to be in seventh heaven. The next one, to the nines. To the nines. We usually use this one with the verb to be dressed. He was dressed to the nines. For their wedding, they were dressed to the nines. What is a los nueves? It means very elegant. Looking sharp, looking good. Dressed to the nines. Well, when do you dress to the nines? When you go to a wedding or a funeral. You got to dress up for a funeral. You don't want to look, you know, you want to at least pay your respects. I'm not saying you got to wear a suit. And speaking of funerals, you say a dos metros bajo tierra. We don't. Okay, we know about the metric system. We don't really use it, though. How would we say it? Otro show muy popular. And this one's called 6 Feet Under. This is a show that was on HBO a long time ago. I remember when I lived in New York, this show was on. 6 feet. I guess that's the equivalent of 2 meters. Or more or less, you know. 6 feet under. The next one, 9 to 5. Another one, this is a song and a movie. Dolly Parton. Working 9 to 5, ain't no way to make a living. Great one. 9 to 5, what does this mean? A job. Yep. If your mom comes up to your room or your dad and knocks on your door when you're a teenager and says, hey man, you can't just play video games all day. You got to get a 9 to 5. You're never going to make any money playing video games. Really? I guess that expression didn't age well. No envejeció muy bien. You'll never make any money playing video games. I know people who do. Lots and lots. They said, I don't need a 9 to 5. So 9 to 5 is not just a job, but it also has the connotation of being like a regular job, a normal, you know, in at 9, out at 5. I know in Spain, it's a different timetable. It's 10 to 6, right? Depending on your lunch time, you take a break. 9 to 5. Great movie. Stars Dolly Parton. She doesn't only do the song, but she also is in the movie. And yes, she's an awesome actress. She's not just a talented singer, but she's also an amazing actress. And the fifth one. The fifth one is to get the third degree. The third degree. De tercer grado. Okay, if we're talking about a burn, right? Una quemadura. We're talking about a third degree burn, right? But if you tell somebody, remember we just said your parents knocking on your door, coming on up to your room and knocking on your door, and they say, Alberto, where were you last night? And who were you with? And what time did you come in? And who drove? And who did this? I'm like, guys, you're giving me the third degree. I'm getting the third degree. And in this case, it means you're interrogating me. This is an interrogation. Another funny way to say this one is, what is this, the Spanish Inquisition? This is not just a funny idiomatic expression, but this is one that was popularized by the very famous Monty Python. Monty Python, you guys know it. He goes, what is this, the Spanish Inquisition? And they come out, nobody expects. I think the line is, I wasn't expecting the Spanish Inquisition, right? The third degree, it's the same thing. And why? And where? And when? And I guess parents, part of their job is to give their kids the third degree. I do it with my daughter. I'm like, and where? And what do you do at school? And what do they say? And what do you? I want to know. I want her to share with me. I don't want her to feel like she's being interrogated at Guantanamo Bay either. But sometimes you got to give them the third degree. So depending on if you're asking the questions or you're being interrogated, I'm getting the third degree, or you're giving me the third degree. And this has a double trouble meaning as well, because if somebody gives you the third degree, maybe it's your university. Ha sacado tres títulos. All right. Now you know why I'm not a comedian. Folks, we have to go to a quick commercial break over here. I can't believe it. Time is just flying by, as always. We've got so much to do in the third and fourth parts of today's show. So stick around. Hey, amigos, welcome back. Welcome back to this Monday's edition of The Show With No Name. I know. Hey, we're almost done with the show. Not really, but half full or half empty? You decide. I know my decision. All right, amigos, come on in. We've got more challenges up ahead in the third part of today's show. Don't forget, this afternoon you've got Kyle Miller and his program Drive Time. You've got Guy Williams in Western Civilization. Dave Boyce and his program, The Salad. That's right, amigos. So many amazing programs, and the way you can make sure you never miss any of them is by following Vaughn Radio on social media, by downloading our free app, and making sure that you participate. And you're more than just a student, but you're part of our community. And if you didn't know it, we have an online community right now, a Vaughn student portal. If you haven't checked it out, go over to our website, or you can find out more information on social media. Just search for whatever social media platform you're using. Search for Grupo Vaughn, search for my name, search for Kyle Miller, Jules Linares, search for Tosh Pasqua, and all of my amigos. And folks, it's time for another challenge. It's time for today's homophone.
Homophones, homophones on the show with no name. It's homophones time, because homophones rhyme. They sound the same on the show with no name. The show with no name. Homophones on the show with no name. Cause homophones time, it's homophone rhyme. They sound the same on the show with no name.
The show with no name.
The show with no homophone.
The
show with no
name.
Show with no
name.
That's right. That's right. Amigos, it's homophones only on the show with no name. And here's where I give you two words, and then you give me the words. But you got to give me the words in I'm going to give them to you in Spanish. And you give them to me in English. And then I want you to go a step further, un paso más allá. And I want you to tell me if the two words sound the same. And as always, what we'll discover in this section is that a lot of words have many meanings. And we discover that in this section. We also discover that in the double trouble section, which let's not get ahead of ourselves. No nos adelantemos. Let's kick it with today's homophones. The first word I'm looking for is the word fianza. It is the payment for somebody's release from jail. Okay? It's also the verb. Okay? What else? We also use this, you'll see this a lot now, when we add the word out to it, it's rescatar. It's what happened a lot of times with banks during financial crises, things like that. It's, sacar de apuros, rescatar. Okay, so this is a very rich word as I go down there. Fianza. Bajo palabra, bajo fianza, and many, many other uses over here. We'll take a look at them a little bit later when we look at both words. But the first word, just to keep it short, fianza, pagar la fianza. Y también si añadimos out es rescatar. Again, if you read the headlines, if you read the media, you'll definitely recognize this word because you hear it a lot. And you also hear it in soccer press as well, sports press. Ooh, there you go. I just gave you another clue on today's first word. Well, actually, I'm lying. You'll hear the second word in the sports press. The second word, which is paca, fardo, o aquí pone en España, bala de heno. So a bundle of hay. Heno is hay. Okay, también es embalar, empacar. All right, so there you go, my amigos. There are your two words. I think you might be familiar with them. We'll see in just a moment when we take a look at your answers. I also have to give you guys the Say What soundbite. This is the third listen of today's Say What soundbite. Please write down what you hear.
You get this straight, shit kicker. Don't you go mistaking me for some whole other body. You got your brains in your dick if you think we're just going to fade away. We're going to be here till this thing's finished.
All right. Sounds like a really nice guy. Or a really good actor. Well, I think I've given you enough clues, and hopefully somebody will be able to figure all of that out before the end of the show. You're going to hear that one more time. And that's in the fourth and final part of the show. All right, but we've got something else pending right now, and that's our homophones. Now, the first word we looked at is the word fianza. This word is spelled B-A-I-L, okay? So he's in prison. He's in jail. The bail is $30,000 or 30 grand. Es otra forma de decir eso. The bail, B-A-I-L. No, it's bail. It's bail, right? B-A-I-L. We don't, it's not like a dual sound in there. It's L, L, like cerveza inglesa, bail, okay? So let me give it to you in context. He was released from jail after his mom paid his bail, su fianza. Okay. Also, we said to bail somebody out. Have you heard this one? Now, this can be literal and figurative. So, thanks a lot. You bailed me out of jail. Me sacaste pagando la fianza. You bailed me out of jail. I really appreciate that. But if we put it into a context of business, to bail a company out or to bail, they're always criticizing that we're bailing out banks. It's pagando su fianza para que se queden libres. Think about it. The same thing, rescatar. Same idea. So the word is bail. B-A-I-L. Okay? Bail. I'm trying to see if does it have any other meanings that I've got here. Bail, the bail. Those are the most common ones, I would say. All right. Now, the second one here, this is a footballer, right? Also a famous actor. They're not related, as far as I know. I'm talking about Christian, and I'm talking about Gareth, for those of you who are Madridistas, or well, I'm sure many of you know who he was. He played in Spain for many, many years. So how do we pronounce his name in English? Because if we know how to pronounce his name, then we know how to pronounce the second word. Gareth Bale. Christian Bale. Do they sound the same? Well, let's put them up next to each other. I'm sorry, Christian Bale. I can't pay your bail. I'm sorry, Christian Bale. I can't bail you out. Right? Para usarlo como sustantivo y como verbo. I can't pay Bale's bail. Do they sound the same? Absolutely. Woo-hoo. Nice job. The second one is spelled B-A-L-E, and the first one is spelled B-A-I-L. And since we're talking about Christian Bale, why not take a look at today's Name That Movie. Name That Movie. That's right, amigos. It's Name That Movie, only on the show with no name. And this is where we learn English from, well, the same source, la misma fuente, the same source as your counterparts, your American, your British, right? The other people who learned English, obviously, as our first language, we learned it via TV. I mean, it wasn't just our parents. I see it with my daughter. My daughter learned some stuff from me. She learns some stuff from her videos that she sings, the YouTube stuff. She learns other stuff from school, and that's how it works. You get a little bit from everything. That's why I always urge you guys to follow my friends on Vaughn Radio, even the teachers that I follow that aren't on Vaughn Radio, because I think they can help you out a lot, right? And if you're following, the good thing about social media is there's no limit to the amount of accounts that you can follow. You can follow 100,000 English accounts if there are that many out there. I'm not sure. But watch movies, watch series. Did you ever think you'd have a teacher who told you to watch more movies, to watch more series? Well, if it's a language teacher, what are we doing here? And it works, guys. I've seen it with my wife. At first, oof, she didn't understand. She would get frustrated even. And now, I come in and she's watching a series and she's watching it in English, even if I'm working or doing something else. So now it's like automatic for her to put it into English. But it wasn't overnight. It was a process, just like everything. You get used to it, right? And now I think she just got used to putting it in English, because I think I was such a pain in the ass. I was such a pain in the neck. Un coñazo. I was like, put it in English. I don't want to watch it in Spanish. Put it in English. And she finally, I think she just, even when I'm not there, to avoid me saying that, she's like, okay, I'm going to put it in English. But as a result of it, her English has improved leaps and bounds. Pegando botes, no, como I'm a saco. Her English has improved leaps and bounds. And every time I send you guys one of these little trivias, which is almost every day on Twitter and on Instagram in my stories, I always put my wife to the test. I'm like, which one of these? And I don't show her the answers because people vote and that could sway her. Eso puedo convencerle, to sway. That can sway her. So I don't share that part. I just say, which one of these is right? And she always gets it right, always. And that just shows that she has gotten so used to English that she knows innately, right? Innately, without thinking about it. It's like muscle memory, as we say. She innately knows that's the one. That's the one. And that's what a native, if you ask another native speaker who's not a teacher, which one's correct, they're not going to tell you that one because it's the present continuous. They won't know that. But they'll know that's obviously not correct. And that one doesn't sound right. So it's that one. That's the one, you know? So just like when in Spanish, when I make a mistake, I'm sure my students instantly are like, right? It gives me away. Me deslata. Is that how you say that? Deslatar. All right. Here is the trailer for today's Name That Movie. In 2006, 2007, a group of investors bet against the U.S. mortgage market. In their research, they discovered how flawed and corrupt the market is. This is based on a true story. It's an awesome movie. If you have not seen it, you are missing out. It's a great movie. You'll learn a lot of great vocabulary, and you'll learn about an interesting time in history when, I'm not going to say too much more. So let's take a look at the trailer here. In 2006, 2007, a group of investors, inversores, you say, we say investors because the verb is to invest. So una inversión, an inversion? Nope, we don't say inversion. Investment, okay? So a group of investors bet against. So you can bet on something or you can bet against something. They bet against the U.S. mortgage market. Let's pronounce that word. Es buenísimo que la palabra hipoteca empieza con muerte en latín, mort. Pero no se pronuncia así, la T es muda. It's more, like más, more, gidge, como bridge, pero con una G. Mortgage. Against the U.S. mortgage market. In their research, en su investigación, they discover how flawed and corrupt the market is. And if something is flawed, it's imperfect, con fallos, right? There were several flaws, F-L-A-W is the word. There are several flaws in the system. I thought you told me the system was flawless. A lot of times we use that word to talk about a diamond, sin imperfecciones. It's flawless. Your comments in our group, they're usually flawless. Okay, you make some mistakes. But those are the mistakes you have to make if you want to learn, right? The mistakes you have to. If we don't make mistakes, what are we doing, right? We're not really learning then, are we? So we look for our flaws, another way of saying our mistakes, our imperfections, and we try and work on them. We polish them quite like a diamond, right? To polish. Limar, limar. All right, let's see over here. The movie is The Big Short. I think in Spanish, what do you say? La Gran Estafa or La Gran Movida or something like this. It's called The Big Short. I think I've recommended this movie to you guys in the past. If you have not seen it, it's awesome. It really is a great movie. I mean, just listen to the cast, El Reparto. Christian Bale. Hey, we just mentioned him. See what I did there? Steve Carell. He's the guy from The American Office. Ryan Gosling, my wife's secret lover in her dreams, and Brad Pitt. I mean, we're talking about a serious, serious cast over here. And again, it's based on a true story, based on the mortgage crisis, the ninja, you know, the subprime mortgage crisis. But the way they tell the story is really interesting. And the director is Adam McKay. I know I've heard his name before. Adam McKay. What has he? He directed The Other Guy. Ah, claro, cómo no. One of my favorite movies, The Other Guys, with Will Ferrell and Mark Wahlberg, and The Rock, and Samuel L. Jackson. Okay, yeah. So Yama, The Other Guys. So I like this director. I like his style. I really enjoy the visual, the music he chooses. There's something about this director's style, Adam McKay, that I really, really like. He also did Anchorman, which is the famous one with Will Ferrell. So as you can see, it wasn't his first time working with the legendary Will Ferrell. So The Big Short, it came out in 2015. Again, check it out. It's awesome. It's really entertaining and interesting. And Jared says, I'm not fucking you, Vinny. No te estoy jodiendo, no te estoy follando. I'm not fucking you, Vinny. I'm kissing you. Te estoy dando un beso. I'm looking deep into your eyes as I make love to you, Vinny. Estoy mirándote profundamente los ojos. We say to look in my eyes. Look me in my eyes, or look in my eyes, or look into my eyes. But we don't say look at my eyes, because look at no es dirigido. Right? Look at my eyes. Are they okay? But if I say, okay, are you lying? Okay, look in my eyes, or look me in the eye and tell me you're not lying. Eso sería la construcción de mírame al ojo, pero no como mírame fijadamente, right? Even though to stare es mirar fijando la mirada, the expression is to look me in my eye. Look me in my eye and say that to me. No, mírame al ojo y me lo dices así. So he says, I'm looking deep into your eyes as I make love to you, Vinny. I'm handing you the deal of the century. Te estoy dando la operación de el siglo. O sea, he's going to make a lot of money, he's telling him. I'm looking deep. He goes, I'm handing you, te estoy entregando. Piénsalo, poner en mano. I'm handing you the deal of the century. You know, century. On a fucking platter. Decimos igual. En bandeja. I gave it to you on a platter, man. De hecho, esa la vamos a apuntar para luego hacer un video en Instagram. Remember, follow me on Instagram for all these little interesting things. But I know you all know it. En bandeja, you say it. Well, in English, we say on a platter. Y si quieres darle énfasis, on a silver platter, ¿no? De plata. So he goes, I'm handing you the deal of the century on a fucking platter. And what do I get out of it? What do I get out of it is, ¿y qué saco yo de esto? ¿No? ¿Qué beneficio saco yo? What do I get out of it? Easy. I've got a $20 million a month negative carry. O sea, me estoy llevando 20 millones en red, right? I've got bosses, tengo jefes, trying to pull the plug. This is a great expression. To pull the plug is acabar algo. Think about this. If somebody is hooked up to life support, to a machine, and the doctor says, listen, we don't want to do it, but we can't really do anything else. We're going to have to pull the plug. Es echar el cierre, finiquitar, desenchufar. Think about it. Acabar con ello. Think about that. Like an old person who's they're breathing on machines, like they're at their final stages of life. And the doctor will say, I think we can pull the plug. There's nothing more we can do. And the patient is just suffering. So great. But we say it too. What happened with that deal? They pulled the plug. Al final, le quitaron el, no lo hicieron. They didn't do it. They ended it, right? Es acabar algo. So they're trying to pull the plug because they think I'm out of my fucking mind. To be out of your mind, estar fuera de tu mente, es estar mal de la cabeza, estar loco. I'm out of my mind. All right, we make this trade, este intercambio. And those problems aren't so big anymore. Ya no son tan grandes. And sure, swaps are a dark market. And to swap is intercambiar, treque. But also swap is en la, el mercado, a ver cómo lo ponen, an exchange or trade, intercambiar, permutar, right? Hacer un treque. You swap one thing for another, you change it. It's a technical term. And sure, swaps are a dark market. So I set the price. Yo pongo el precio. And we looked at this. I shared a video with this one. Price, dilo conmigo, precio. Price y premio. Prize. Very different. Price, precio, prize. Okay? So I set the price, whatever price I want. And when you come for the payday, and payday is el día en que te pagan, el día que te forras. No, el día de que te paguen la nómina, pero aquí en un crimen es el día que cobramos. That would be the way to say it, el día que cobramos. And when you come for the payday, I'm going to rip your eyes out. Voy a arrancarte los ojos. Really nice. I'm going to rip your eyes out and I'm going to make a fortune. Voy a forrarme. I'm going to make a fortune. But the good news is, Vinny, la buena noticia es, you're not going to care. No te va a importar. You're not going to care because you're going to make so much fucking money. That's what I get out of it. Eso es el provecho que le saco yo. That's what I get out of it. You want to know what you get out of it? ¿Quieres saber qué beneficio le sacas tú? You want to know what you get out of it? You get the ice cream. Tú tienes el helado. Mira el get. ¿Cuántas veces ha usado get aquí? Hemos empezado el show con get. You get the ice cream, the hot fudge, the banana, and the nuts. Right now, eso lo sabes, ¿no? So ice cream, fácil. Hot fudge es el lo que ponen encima del brownie, este chocolate, que es it's gooey and it's hot. The banana, eso es fácil. And the nuts, los frutos secos. Right now, I get the sprinkles. The sprinkles son lo de los colores, right? What you put on top. And yeah, if this goes through, si esto cumple, si esto sigue, I get the cherry. And this is a great expression too, the cherry on top, la guinda. Also, it's the icing on the cake. Just don't mix them up. The cherry on top, it's not the icing on top and the cherry on the cake. I'll say it's the cherry on top and the icing on the cake. Es el glacé. He goes, I get the cherry. He says, but you get the sundae, Vinny. Eso es un homófono para domingo. Sounds exactly the same. You get the sundae. And Vinny says, all right, I buy that. Lo decís igual, yo lo compro. I buy that. Thank you. And Jared says, so what do you say? What are you? Esto lo hemos visto varias veces. What are you? What do you? What are you? What are you? Okay. What do you say? Dilo, what are you? Suena como árabe. What are you? What are you? Oh, what are you? What are you? Right? What do you say? ¿Qué me dices? You want me to make you a market? ¿Quieres que te crea un mercado? And Vinny says, yeah, we'll take 50 million. Garibaldi 4 BBB. These, I guess it's a company and the kind of stock. Remember, we can call them stocks or shares, pero la bolsa is called the stock market. And then Jared answers, sharpen your pencils. So sharpen is hacerlos con punta. You use a pencil sharpener to sharpen your pencil, right? And then once it's sharp, el adjetivo sharp, el verbo sharpen. Sharpen your pencils. I'll get the paperwork ready. Yo prepararé el papeleo. So I guess this person is going to sign on the dotted line. Va a firmar en la línea perforada, you say? To sign on the dotted line. Ojo con esa también. No es sing, es sign. Firmar. And firma? Signature. And then Vinny hangs up the phone. Remember, to pick up, coger, to hang up, colgar. And he says, fuck you too. Que te den a ti también. I love this movie. Check it out. It's The Big Short. Folks, we're off to our fourth and final commercial break. I hope you're enjoying the show. And I hope you're learning a lot with us here on The Show With No Name. We'll be right back with the fourth and final part of today's show. So stick around. Hey, welcome back. Welcome back, amigos. It's time for the fourth and final part of today's show with no name. Welcome back. Welcome back. Can't believe how fast today's show is just flying by. Thank you to all of you for your effort, your energy, and your excitement. Keep up the great work, amigos. Remember, keep it locked here at Vaughn Radio and you'll learn English all day long. The best way is to download our free Vaughn Radio app. And this way, you never miss any of your shows. Also, follow us on social media. It's Grupo Vaughn. And you can stop by our websites. We got GrupoVaughn.com, where you can find everything. And you've got the Vaughn Tienda, VaughnTienda.com, where you guys can pick up materials, all of our amazing materials. All right, amigos, welcome back. Welcome back to this, the fourth and final part of today's show. I know, it's flown by for me too. It's time for today's Double Trouble.
Double Trouble, baby. Yeah, you know what time it is. Give it up.
Double. Come on.
Double Trouble.
Yeah.
I said double.
Uh-huh.
Double trouble.
Yeah.
Double.
Come on.
Double trouble.
Yeah.
I said double. Double trouble.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. You know it. It is time for our double trouble. I'm taking a look at this one and, oh, man. This one's going to make you sweat a little bit. And I want to make you sweat. Sweat till you can't sweat no more. All right, let's take a look here before I make it rain. No pudo arreglárselas o aguantar como cómico. Todos le llamaron aficionado barra no le tomaron en serio. Okay, again, I try and translate things. I look it up. Then I get the main idea, but I'm always open to alternate translations. I'm learning Spanish the same way you're learning English. So I try and get, a lot of times when it's an idiomatic expression, I try and get the main idea, the feeling, when you would use it, if you noticed, okay? So no pudo arreglárselas o aguantar, ¿no? Como cómico. Todos le llamaron aficionado. Or, you know, aficionado, principiante, no le tomaron en serio. Okay? That is today's double trouble. Hopefully you guys will be able to figure that out. Also, we've got to listen to our Say What soundbite for the fourth and final time. Please write down what you hear.
You get this straight, shit kicker. Don't you go mistaking me for some whole other body. You got your brains in your dick if you think we're just going to fade away. We're going to be here till this thing's finished.
All right. There you go, folks. There you go. Nobody has figured it out yet, but I got to have faith. I got to have faith. Yeah, why not? A little faith never hurt anybody, como decimos en inglés. All right, let's go on over to today's double trouble. Seems like it's giving you guys some trouble because I'm looking here in our virtual classroom and I don't see anybody participating. Not in this section, not yet. Is it because you guys are racking your brains? Exprimiendo los sesos, I think you say. Is it because you're racking your brains? I hope so. I hope it's not because you've given up. Te has dado por vencido. So no pudo arreglárselas o aguantar la vida. Como cómico, todos le llamaron aficionado, principiante, vamos, que no le tomaron en serio como esa profesión. All right, let's take a look. Let's take the first part. No pudo arreglárselas, aguantar. He couldn't hack it. Now, to hack, you know, from being a hacker, right? But to hack literally means to cut something, right? So if you can't hack it, it means you can't take it, right? I'm sorry, man. This is a difficult business. Not everybody can hack it as a Wall Street investor, hablando de la película de antes, right? As a stockbroker, un accionista, alguien que trabaja en la bolsa as a stockbroker. It's a difficult life. Not everybody can hack it, aguantarlo, arreglárselas, sobrevivir, to hack. It's a great word, because I know you know it, hacker, él es un hacker. And to hack, if you think about it, as I said, is to cut. So, ¿qué están haciendo con tu programa? Okay, no con un hacha de verdad, pero they're putting holes in it, right? They're hacking it into pieces. Makes sense. I'm sure you've also heard of life hacks, truquitos de la vida. So another way, another thing that is hack is, look, it says life hack. Datos útiles, trucos de vida. So a hack, computer hacks, cosas que te pueden usar, ayudar a la hora de usar el ordenador. En ese caso es como atajo o truquillo, right? A life hack, so dependiendo lo que va adelante, right? Computer hack, gym hack. Te vamos a enseñar, lo usan muchísimo, guys. This is why you have to follow English speaking accounts. Here's a gym hack. Always have a glass of water before. Eso sería un truquito del gimnasio. So hack. And to hack it, sacarlo, arreglárselas, right? You can't hack it, man. New York City's a tough city. A lot of people can't hack it in New York City, all right? So that's the first part. He couldn't hack it as a comedian. They called him a hack. That's right. So a hack, it says here, si estamos hablando de periodista, because they used to just use it for journalism. It's escritorzuelo, gacetillero, it says here. It's an inferior, alguien que no es profesional, right? A hack. Here, let me give you this example. Amateurish, aficionado. This salesman, right? A salesman or a car dealer is un concesionario. This salesman tried to sell a car to a homeless guy. What a hack, right? Vaya aficionado el tío. He won't be able to hack it. No podrá aguantar o perdurar mucho tiempo. I don't think he's going to be able to hack it as a car dealer. And we looked at the word deal before too. Hey, we're looking at a lot of double, triple, and quadruple troubles here on today's show. And you all know those are great ways to come up with jokes for our section called You're Joking.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, what did the guy say when he walked into the bar? Ouch. Ouch. You get it? Ouch. He walked into the bar.
You're joking.
That's right, folks. You're joking. This is where we look at some jokes, and hopefully you guys get the jokes. If you don't, no worries. I'll explain the hilarious jokes after. Okay, they're not hilarious. Hilarious. Hilarante. I think you say the same thing, right? No se usa mucho, but hilarious. Very, very funny. We also say hysterical. It's another way of saying it. Que también puede decir, man, you lost your cool. Perdiste los estribos. You were hysterical yesterday. What happened? But also, oh man, I love inviting Bob to our dinners because he's hysterical. Contexto es todo. Más cuando una palabra puede tener 80 mil millones de significados, ¿no? Okay, so what do you call a candle in armor? Okay, what do you call a candle in armor? Una vela con armadura. Oh, easy. A nightlight. Nightlight? No? No? Nobody? Did anybody get it? Which is a little bit different than a light night, right? Un caballero que no come mucho is a light night. Night siendo caballero. Yeah, a light night. You get it now? All right. So what do you call a candle in armor? A night light. You get it? Night light. Un caballero. Light es luz. Lit up es iluminado. Light, lit, lit. Es un verbo irregular. And what is a night light then? Well, I remember I slept with a night light till I was like 18 years old. Okay, I just admitted it. Ya está admitido todo. A night light. It's these little lights that you put in the hallway, in el pasillo, so you can see where you're walking if you have to go pee in the middle of the night. And it also keeps the ghosts away and the monsters. Los mantiene a raya, a los monstruos y fantasmas. Yeah, a night light. Right? Night lights. I remember my grandma, put on the night light. Mom, put on the night light. I wouldn't go to sleep without that night light. You say lamparita, luz de noche, luz nocturna. It's one of these ones that you plug right into the wall and it's just there to light the way. It's not a bright light. So do you get it now? What do you call a candle in armor? A night light? Well, at least I didn't say John Wick. John Wick. No. Wick is, how do you say it now in Spanish? I forgot it. I used to know the word, the wick. Oh, see, you can't remember everything. And I knew I know it because I've used it before. Mecha. The wick of a candle is la mecha. Speaking of things you plug into the wall like a nightlight, air wick, the air freshener, que tiene una mecha, pero de aire, no es fuego. Get out of here. Y John Wick, pues ahí lo tienes. So what do you call a candle in armor? A night light. And what do you call an owl with armor? ¿Qué llamas a un búho con armadura? A night owl. No? Same joke, kind of. Night, caballero. A night owl, un búho caballero, or a night owl, una persona nocturna. Okay, all right, all right. All right, last one. Last one. What do you call a warrior that's going to bed? Okay, what do you call a warrior, un guerrero, who's going to bed? Y fijaos, no he dicho going to the bed. We just say going to bed, sin el the. Apúntalo. So what do you call, what do you, ahí está el what do you. Quiero que apuntéis las veces que yo digo what do you. What do you call a warrior, excuse me, ahora no digo el otro bien. What do you call a warrior that's going to bed? A night-night. Oh, jeez. Night-night? No. Bueno, esto es un saludo. Cuando despides a un bebé por la noche, you say night-night. Right? So, a mimir. Night, night. Don't let the bed bugs bite. Yeah, it's a weird one. Que no te muerden los chinches. Don't let the bed bugs bite. Pero lo hacemos porque rime. Night, night. Don't let the bed bugs bite. So you get it now? What do you call a warrior that's going to bed? A night, night. All right, guys, I'll stop, but only because it's time for famous birthday trivia. That's right, amigos. That's right. It's famous birthdays only on the show with no name. And guys, I think we're getting through Monday in style. I think we're having fun. We're learning. Don't forget, you can continue to learn here on Vaughn Radio. We've got programs all afternoon long, and all these programs have one aim, one objective, one goal, and that's to have you guys enjoy learning English. And if you can do that, then you'll learn a little bit every day. I know I see it here on the show. You guys are learning constantly. And you're proving it to me. Me lo estáis encima Me lo estáis demostrando. You're proving it to me. You're not just learning. You're showing me. Ah, Alberto, check this one out. Check that one out. All right, let's see if we can figure out today's famous birthdays. The first person was born in 1974, and his name is Fardo. Fardo. And his first name is my mother. Alguien que su fe es cristianismo. So, hey, we're going back in full circle here. A British actor, and he has received various accolades. You say palmares, accolades, including an Academy Award, two Golden Globe Awards. And let me tell you what you've seen him in. His breakthrough role, el que todo el mundo le conoció, his breakthrough role was at age 13. He was in Steven Spielberg's war film, Empire of the Sun. This was from 1987. Then he was in American Psycho. Wait, this just blew my mind. He played Patrick Bateman. And then he went on to play Batman. O sea, sacamos una E de Patrick Bateman. Yes, Patrick Batman. Maybe that was a premonition, an omen, un presagio. Well, he was in American Psycho in 2000. He was in The Machinist in 2004. In 2005, he started doing the trilogy, the Dark Knight trilogy. Batman Begins, The Dark Knight, 2008, and Dark Knight Rises, 2012. He was also in Terminator Salvation. He was in The Big Short, which is today's Name That Movie. So if you were paying attention, I said this person's name in Name That Movie and in the homophones section. And also, this guy has gotten a reputation of being difficult to work with. You can hear an audio of him losing his shit, losing his marbles, losing his mind on the set of Terminator. You can find it. Put in YouTube, this guy's name, si lo sabes, and tirade. A tirade is cuando se pone a gritar, or screaming, angry. Put something like that. You should be able to find it. This next person was born in 1951, and I can't even imagine this person being a Devo. Not at all. He seems like a really nice guy. He's an English drummer, singer, songwriter, producer, and actor. He was the drummer and lead singer of Genesis. And he was the one who told us, against all odds, contra todo pronóstico, take a look at me now. Him and against all odds. De ahí aprendemos contra todo pronóstico, against all odds. Hey, think twice. It's just another day for you and me in paradise. Or what about, I can feel it coming in the air tonight. Oh, Lord. Classic over here. And last but not least, speaking of classics, an American actor who was born today in 1930. He's won two Academy Awards, four Golden Globes, and a Partridge in a Pear Tree. Well, he's been in so many movies. He was in The French Connection in 1971, so a long time ago. The Unforgiven, Bonnie and Clyde, Mississippi Burning, what else? Ants, Enemy of the State, Get Shorty, Superman 2, Superman, the original, 1978. We mentioned this guy a while back. I love this guy. He is awesome. And his last name we looked at in our Double Trouble. Well, part of his last name. All right, we've got our famous birthday boys and girls. Number one, Christian Bale. If he gets in trouble, you'll have to bail him out. Number two, Phil Collins. He really fills my heart with joy. And last but not least, Gene Hackman, who showed everybody that he really could hack it as an actor. And this is Gene Hackman in the movie Mississippi Burning. It's in 1998. And yes, it's a Southern accent from Mississippi. And this is... He's grabbing the other guy by the balls, por los huevos. And he goes, now get this straight. Que quede claro esto. Get this straight, shit kicker. A shit kicker es como un mierdas. You know, no vale. Estás pateando mierda. ¿Qué haces con tu vida? You're a shit kicker, he says. Don't you go mistaking me for some whole other body. No me vayas confundiendo por. So mistake es un error. But to mistake somebody for somebody es confundirles por. So it's a different usage. Don't you go mistaking me for some whole other body. You got your brains in your dick. Tienes los cerebros en tu polla. If you think we're just going to fade away, desaparecer, desvanecer. We're going to be here till this thing is finished. Vamos a estar aquí hasta que acabe este rollo. All right, this is Gene Hackman, the birthday boy in Mississippi Burning.
Where'd it go? Oh! You get this straight, shit kicker. Don't you go mistaking me for some whole other body. You got your brains in your dick if you think we're just going to fade away. We're going to be here till this thing's finished.
All right, there you go, folks. And it's time for our final section, Name That Lyric.
Hi, hello, Alberto. I think the song is... No? Sorry, bye.
Name that lyric. Name that lyric. Name that lyric. Name that lyric. Only on the show with no name. The show with no name. The show with no name. Name that lyric. Only on the show with no name.
That's right, amigos. That's right. It's Name That Lyric only on the show with no name. And thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your hard work. Thank you for the magic you bring to the show every day. And thank you, thank you, thank you for choosing to learn English with me, with The Show With No Name, with FYI, with Fawn Radio. Remember, right after today's show, you've got Jules Linares and her awesome program, Let's Get Random. Don't miss it. It's on right after this. In fact, you got time to take a quick pee. Hey, I've got to do it too. In fact, as soon as this is over, I know where I'm going. Pee break, or as we say too, you guys say the same thing, parada técnica, a pit stop. I got to make a pit stop over here at the bathroom. Well, it happens. It happens sometimes. If you guys know me all throughout the show, because I talk for 2 hours straight, 2 horas sin parar, I've got water, I've got tea. So I'm constantly drinking. And what does that mean? I'm constantly peeing. I know. TMI, too much information. But I'll tell you what, guys, I know it's Monday, but you deserve it. Crack open a beer. Enjoy it. It's on me. Invito yo. Enjoy that ice cold brew. The word brew is another way to say beer. A brew. A brewski. You guys deserve it. Wonderful work today and every day. And let's take a look at today's song lyric in our Name That Lyric section. In fact, I'll give it to you. It's A Groovy Kind of Love by Phil Collins. And I want to look at this word groovy really quick, because groovy is like an antiquated way of saying chuli, right? Bacán, hondero, guay, estupendo. So it's interesting because he's being corny on purpose. Tenemos un amor chachi piruli is what he's saying. We got a groovy kind of love. So let's take a look. We looked at the first line already. We talked about being blue, melancólico, triste. When I'm feeling blue, all I have to do is take a look at you. That's right, students, at you guys. Then I'm not so blue. Entonces, no soy tan triste. They're not talking about Smurfs there. What do you call them? Pitufos. When you're blue in English, it means you're sad. When you're close to me, cuando estás cerca, I can hear your heartbeat. Oigo el latido de tu corazón. I can hear you breathing in my ear. Te noto respirar me al oído. Wouldn't you agree? No estarías de acuerdo. No estás de acuerdo. Wouldn't you agree, baby, you and me, we got a groovy kind of love. Tenemos un amor chachi peruli. Baby, you and me, we got a groovy kind of love. Anytime you want to, you can turn me on to anything you want to. O sea, en cualquier momento que quieras, me puedes sugerir, hacer que haga lo que tú quieras. En cualquier momento. Anytime at all. So there it is. It's a beautiful song. It's a groovy kind of love, and I hope you guys will sing it with me. I feel like we, here on the show with no name, we've got a groovy kind of love together. Thank you so much for hanging out and learning English with us, and we'll be back tomorrow with more Show with No Name. I promise.
When I'm feeling blue.
It's hard to sing like him.
When I'm feeling blue. All I have to do.